my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Tuesday, October 19th, 2010. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Please leave a comment when you're done watching. Even if you just say hi or thanks, I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day, and we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a view showing two charts for the US dollar Canadian dollar currency pair as those charts looked at 6:45 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform using FX Bootcamp's custom layout. On the left is a 15-minute chart, and on the right is an hourly chart with daily pivot points. And yes, you heard me right. I did say dollar CAD. I fielded a question about this pair from one of our regular members at about this time during my live coaching session at London Lunch. Although this member was contemplating a short on this pair, one of the first things I mentioned is that there was also a case for a long. Over the past 4 hours, there have been a couple of notable bounces at about 1.0190. One right there, and a second one right there. We've also got the 55 EMA on this chart. That's the upper sloping blue line. The 55 EMA currently sitting very close to 1.0190. Now that 55 EMA is a prospective source of dynamic support in this case. And finally, if I conduct a Fibonacci study of the move up from today's low on the left-hand portion of the chart right there, Fib study from there to today's high formed just recently right there, I see that the 50% Fib retracement level of that move up also sits near 1.0190. There's the 50% Fib represented by the horizontal lime green line. Besides, the dollar has been on the firm side ever since the early part of last Friday's New York session, so you do have recent trend working in your favor as well. Less than 10 minutes later, the dollar CAD did bounce at 1.0190. There you see the balance at that level plus the 55 EMA. If you took the long at or near 1.0190, you got some help about 10 minutes later from the People's Bank of China. The central bank in the world's second largest economy announced a surprise rate hike at that time. It was announced just after 7 a.m. New York time. Its first rate hike by the People's Bank of China since December of 2008. At this point here, at the close of this green candle, if you took the long, you're sitting on roughly 30 pips of profit depending on your entry. That's certainly a reasonable point at which to move your stop to break even and let this thing run. Now, if you missed that long, chill out and remember what I mentioned in my last video review that was of Friday's New York session. Not always, but often, Forex will give you a second chance. Now, think about that decision by China. Policy tightening moves by their central bank bring the potential to flip the risk on, risk off trade. Flip it to the risk-off position. Now, that's usually what's happened earlier this year when the People's Bank of China raised bank reserve requirements. On those occasions, on those days when that happened, the Australian dollar tended to weaken the most, not surprisingly given that country's close trade ties with China, that is. Also, what happened on those occasions when China tightened policy via bank reserve requirements rising, the Japanese yen tended to gain strength. Now, more recently, the U.S. dollar has been the most popular risk-on or risk-off trade. A risk-off scenario would be a dollar positive, and the dollar has been firming up anyway since last Friday, probably because it became oversold and possibly because Fed QE2 was essentially baked in and some traders have started to cover their dollar shorts. Now, by the way, see my video review from last Friday for details on that. Now, given all of that, we turned our attention at about this point in the live class to the Aussie-USD currency pair. This is a 3-minute chart without indicators for the Australian dollar US dollar currency pair as it looked a few minutes after 7 a.m. New York time. Now, the drop in this pair since the China rate announcement has totaled about 60 pips. That dropped from about here to there. And in doing so, this pair broke below today's lows established earlier. I'm talking about the lows right there, also right there. Now, let's define those lows with a horizontal black line. Now let's zoom in on this chart a bit to make the candles easier to see. There we go. Now, over the next 3 minutes, we get a newly formed swing low near 98.10. You can see that swing low on the lower right-hand portion of the chart. I've just circled it in blue. Now, that swing low could be the basis for a new Fib study. Now, if I draw that Fib study using also the swing high up here, a swing high formed before minutes before the news from China hit the markets, I learned that the 38.2% Fib retracement level of that move down, represented here by the horizontal red line that I'm identifying now with a red arrow, that Fib level sits hardly a pip below that black line I just added. Now, that black line was a level of support several hours ago, and now it may represent an area of resistance. That's an example of roll reversal. So, the basis for a short at or near the 98.40 level was a test of a combination of a roll reversal level plus a 38.2% Fib on the back of news, which could fuel both Aussie weakness and dollar strength. Now, you had more than one chance to short at 98.40 during the formation of these two most recent 3-minute candles. You can see a couple touches at the top of those candles right there. Now, if you took the shot at or near 98.40, your stop loss could be initially positioned for catastrophic protection purposes just above 99.00, a level which generally defines today's London session highs. And one exit strategy in this case could be to take a loss if this pair rises above the 61.8% Fib, represented here by the horizontal blue line just above 98.60. Okay, let's fast forward this chart to the London close. This short trade on the Aussie-USD likely tested traders' patience a bit, but as the old saying goes, patience did pay off. Now, if you put your stop loss at break-even after the first dip below 9800, which occurred right in here, that's the first dip below 9800, and then you let the trade run, and then you close the trade when it reached the weekly M1 pivot point, as it did down here. By the way, the entry we discussed just a moment ago was back there. Now, if you entered back there, closed the trade at the weekly M1, you were rewarded to the tune of about 120 pips. And folks, that is a big trade for this pair during the course of a New York session. Oh, by the way, back to that long trade on dollar CAD. I mentioned earlier a long trade entry on this pair at or near 1.0190, that entry back on the lower left-hand portion of the chart, which I've circled here in blue, and that level 1.0190 represented by the horizontal black line at the bottom of this 3-minute chart for the dollar CAD. A conservative exit strategy on that long would have been to close the trade somewhere in here, which was minutes before a rate decision from the Bank of Canada. That if you close the trade there or near there, you earn a profit of between 90 and 100 pips on that long. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Tuesday, October 19th.